In 2014, in a Santa Barbara, California vineyard, an applicator who had finished applying sulfur piled his empty pesticide bags for disposal. As he flattened the bags, sulfur blew into his eyes. He was wearing regular glasses rather than the required eye protection and developed eyelid swelling, redness, and eye irritation. Luckily, the accident didn't cause permanent eye damage. This is a real example of pesticide exposure that can happen when proper personal protective equipment, PPE, is not worn. This is Miguel. He works in pesticide-treated fields wearing regular work clothes. He's got on a long-sleeve shirt, long pants, work boots, and socks, even though you can't see them. Work clothes are a barrier. They reduce Miguel's risk of pesticide exposure because they cover most of his body and can help keep pesticides from entering. Pesticides can enter the body through the skin, eyes, nose, and mouth. Skin contact is the most frequent route of pesticide exposure. Pesticides that spill or splash can get on skin, especially when not wearing the appropriate PPE. If work clothes are worn multiple times without washing them, pesticide residues left on them can contact the skin. Pesticides can enter eyes from splashing during mixing or loading, or from rubbing them after working with pesticide-contaminated equipment, or touching plants in pesticide-treated areas. Without proper PPE, even small droplets or mist containing pesticides can drift into the eyes. Breathing dust or vapor during mixing or application without wearing a respirator or not wearing it properly can cause a person to inhale pesticides through his nose, resulting in pesticides entering the lungs. From there, the pesticides can be transported to other parts of the body. Pesticides can enter the mouth most commonly by spray or blowing dust during mixing or application. However, smoking while handling pesticides or eating right after handling them without washing up properly also increases the chance of ingesting pesticides. A handler can contaminate his cigarette or food and end up ingesting pesticides through his mouth. The most frequent way that pesticides enter the body is through the skin. Some pesticides may cause a mild rash, while others may cause more severe injuries, such as a burn. If a pesticide is absorbed through the skin, blood can carry it to organs within the body. The pesticide's chemical characteristics and formulation determines how aggressively a pesticide can penetrate the skin. For example, oil-soluble pesticides, such as an emulsifiable concentrate, can pass through the skin easier than water-soluble pesticides, such as soluble liquids and powders. Did you know that not all of the skin absorbs pesticides at the same rate? The skin on the palm of the hand is tough and thick, and it's harder for pesticides to penetrate. However, skin on the top of the hand is thinner and more delicate and absorbs pesticides more easily. Skin on the forehead is softer and would absorb pesticides faster than the palm, for example. Touching the forehead to wipe sweat can expose the face to pesticides. Touching other parts of the body before washing hands can result in pesticide exposure as well. The skin around the genital area is particularly sensitive and can readily absorb pesticides. It is essential to wash your hands before going to the bathroom to avoid transferring pesticides to this area. This is true for men and women. Keep in mind that leather belts can also absorb pesticides. So after Miguel touches his belt, he should be sure to wash his hands and should not reuse the belt for non-pesticide handling activities. Hand washing is an important and effective way to protect your health in general. Wash hands thoroughly with soap and water. Do not use hand sanitizer. Dry hands on single-use disposable towels. Remember, hand washing does not replace the need for wearing personal protective equipment. Cover the hands and other parts of the body with PPE to help prevent pesticide exposure. The most serious incidents of pesticide exposure occur during accidental splashes or spills when pesticide containers are mishandled during transportation, storage, or if workers are careless during mixing and application. Not following the label directions or taking safety precautions when handling pesticides can also lead to serious incidents of pesticide exposure. Not wearing the proper PPE when applying pesticides or when entering a recently treated field without paying attention to restricted entry intervals, REI, can lead to exposure. Also, spraying when others are nearby can expose others to pesticides. Pesticide exposure can cause various types of injury. Some exposure may be contact, while others may be systemic. Contact symptoms are mostly visible externally, while systemic symptoms are more internal. Contact skin symptoms are the most common form of pesticide injury or overexposure to applicators. Contact symptoms may be skin irritation, itching, redness, rashes, blisters, or burns. Many pesticides can also cause eye, nose, or mouth irritation, such as stinging, swelling, or burning. Common symptoms of systemic injury include breathing problems, sweating, chills, headache, cramps, muscle aches, nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea. The type of personal protective equipment worn depends on the pesticide being applied and on the method of application. Minimum PPE is described by the label and state regulations. In some instances, pesticide handlers may want to wear more than what is required to increase their level of protection. However, wearing excess PPE can lead to heat stress, especially in high temperatures. Always check the label and state regulations to make sure there are no restrictions. In summary, pesticides can pose human health hazards when they enter the body. Pesticides can enter the body primarily through the skin, but also through the eyes, nose, and mouth. The most serious incidents of pesticide exposure occur during accidents of spills or splashes, when pesticide containers are mishandled, or if workers are careless. All pesticide handlers are required to wear PPE to reduce their exposure. They must follow all PPE instructions on the product label and the state laws and regulations. Remember, it's the law.